I've condensed 7 years of lighting experience into one video. I'm going to show you how to light a product in Blender beautifully, and it can apply to most other 3D software. Right, let's get started. All right, so let's first add a plane. Make sure it's in the center and go to view, cameras, active camera to look through the camera. And also, if you have the 3D cursor in the middle here and in the transform pivot point, you have it selected. When we then rotate, we will rotate around the middle of the scene. This is much easier to move the camera because then we will be always looking at the center of the screen. And let's also go into the camera settings and change the focal length to 120 millimeters. This is because we don't want too much distortion on the lens when taking pictures of products, because we want to show the products exactly how they look. Let's scale this scene up. We can also rotate the camera a little bit down. I think this looks good. All right, so we need something to actually light. So let's add a sphere in the start. We'll start simple with a sphere and then we'll move on to actual product very soon. Also shade smooth this sphere. Then let's turn on the render preview like this. And let's start with something you might have heard about, the 3-point lighting. So for this, first we need a key light. So let's add an area light. And again, change the pivot point to 3D cursor. And if you rotate now, it will rotate around the scene, which is very useful. And for the key light will be the most important light. So I like to put this in front and then tilt it a little bit. I think we can also move it further away. I think this is a good location. Okay, so one issue now is that you see the shadows here. They might be a little bit too dark, especially the shadow behind here. And the way we often fix that with is with a fill light. But this doesn't need to be a light. I like to use a plane instead. So let's add a plane, scale this down, and let's place this on the side of the sphere like this. And of course, we don't want to see this plane. So go into object properties and scroll down to visibility and disable camera and shadow. So now we basically have an invisible plane here that reflects this light onto the sphere. And what this does is that it softens out the shadow a little bit. So if you hide this plane now, we'll see it's very dark. And if we unhide it, we will see that we have a nice soft shadow here. And if you see here, we have an ugly line here. So to fix this, let's just move it up a little bit. I think this is good. And for the last light, let's add a backlight. And that is exactly what it sounds like. It's a light we put behind the object to add some backlight. And of course, we don't want this ugly light on the floor here. So to fix this, go into object properties, scroll down to shading, under light linking, press new, and let's drag the floor object into the light linking here and disable this check mark. Now it will not light up the floor, but it will light up the sphere. And the point of the backlight is basically to add a nice rim light around the subject. And if you're enjoying the video, make sure to subscribe. And if you have a suggestion for a tutorial, make sure to comment below. I read every single comment and your suggestions are amazing. So thanks for that. All right, on with the video. All right, so we just lit a sphere. So what do you think the next one is? And it's a default cube. So of course we have to delete this later. So let's just put a cube in here. Now let's add a light and you might spot some problems. Problem is that the edges are way too sharp and the surfaces are way too flat and boring. And a way to improve this is to add some bevels. And we have two ways of improving this. The one way is to do it in material. So let's add a new material. Let's also make it metallic because then it's easier to see. Turn the roughness down a little bit. And let's add a bevel node. And when we connect this into the normal, you will see that the edges soften up, but it is kind of too strong right now. So let's turn the radius down to 0.02. I think that's nice. And already, if we now try to move the light around, we get some nice edges here. And that already makes the cube look more realistic. But there are some issues. If we zoom in, we will still see the original edge because this is only happening in the shader, not in the mesh itself. So the best way to add bevels is of course to do it manually. So let's remove this bevel shader and go into modifiers and let's add a bevel modifier. Let's do 5 segments and let's make it 0.03. So now our bevels are much higher quality and you can see it already looks more realistic. All right, let's move on to actually lighting a real product. And of course, if you want this Blender file, go to my Patreon and you can get it over there. There you will also get all the assets I used in this tutorial. All right, so let's start with a 3-point lighting on this one. So as before, add a key light. You can also make this a bit stronger, maybe 25. And when we have a nice key light, let's add a fill. So add a plane like before. Let's place this in front of the object like this. Let's also go into object properties and go into visibility, turn off camera and shadow so it's invisible. Now we have softened up the shadows here. And let's also make the backlight. So let's duplicate this and let's rotate it around. And I like to move the light around until I find the perfect spot. For example, here, if you look at the top here, I don't want it to be flat and all white. So if you move it slightly more, rotate it, we can get a nice gradient like this. And I think this looks nice. Of course, we don't want it to be bright here. So like before, let's go into object properties. On light linking, click new and let's drag the floor into the light linking and disable the check mark. And I think we can make this a little bit weaker, so let's do 5. So imagine you're making a teaser and you don't want to show the entire product. Then I like to only work with backlights. So let's add a light and let's put it behind the product. And again, let's also add a light group and drag the floor into it and disable it so it doesn't light up the floor. And I think this looks nice. We can also duplicate this light with Shift D and then rotate one to the other side. Make sure it's more or less symmetric. And now we have a pretty cool teaser for a product. All right, for this one, we're lighting it for e-commerce, which is basically product images for websites, and they often have a completely white background. So let's try to light it like that. So add a light. And let's move it up. Let's make this larger and pretty strong. I think that looks nice. And I also like to duplicate it. So Shift D to duplicate it. And for the second one, let's make it really small. And let's make this weaker. This is just to add a nice specular like this, because if you just have a larger light, we won't get any reflections because it's too large. If you have a small one, it's easier to see the reflections. And we also want to make our background white. So let's disable render preview for now. Let's take the floor. Make it much smaller. I think this is good. And go into edit mode, select this edge. Let's extrude it up with E. Let's select this edge here and Control B to bevel it. Let's bevel it like this, scroll up to add detail and also make sure it's shaded smooth and that it covers the entire area here. And if you go into render mode now, we have a white background, but we want to make it a bit wider. So let's also copy this light and make it a little bit smaller and put it behind. So if you click render now, we have a product nicely lit for e-commerce. And it's a little bit dark still, so we can make this, I think, stronger. And I think that looks nice. All right, so for the next one, we're lighting glass. And glass is often pretty hard to light. Imagine you have a simple lighting setup like this. Then you want to show the glass a little bit more. So let's try lighting it up. Add an air light. Let's put it behind the glass. And you'll probably see that it looks kind of ugly because it's completely white and this edge is just completely sharp, which doesn't really look nice. So to fix this, go into the air light, go into the shaders, click use nodes, and let's add a gradient. And let's add this one, which we call elliptical sharper. And you can make gradients like this yourself in Blender nodes. But to keep it simple, I made them as textures. You can also get them in the Patreon. So let's connect this into the emission color. And now let's move this light behind the glass. Let's rotate it down a little bit, make it maybe take it a bit closer. And the light already looks much, much better. Of course, this isn't physically accurate, but it works really well to make the glass just look nicer and smoother. You can also change the color of the light to make it a bit more interesting. All right, so for next one, we're lighting a metallic object. With metallic, it's very similar to how we lit our glass. So let's add an area light. And we have the same problem that it looks very ugly because the edges here are so sharp, even when we put it in front like this. So we have to go into the shader editor, click use nodes on the light, add our gradient and connect it into color. And now we already have much nicer looking light. So I also like to scale it up in the z-axis, make it really tall, a little bit wider, and also make it stronger. And let's put two lights in the background on each side. And let's put two lights in the front like this, because we don't want too much black areas on our metal bottle like this. And now we have lit a pretty nice metallic object. You can also use HRIs to add some detail, but I try to use HRIs sparingly because you don't have full control over the lighting. And with products, you often want to have full control. And for last one is when to use a sunlight. Sometimes you have a product with very flat colors and matte surface. And in these situations, you can't really play with the reflections and make it look nice. And I often like to use sunlight. So let's add a sunlight here. Let's rotate it like this. And we're already getting a nice light here. So a sunlight is often used if you want hard shadows, which often work well with products that have a very strong flat color. You will often see it in like summertime commercials, like for sunscreen and things like that. And you can also soften the shadows if you want by increasing the angle on the sunlight like this. And for this, to add some more visual interest, I like to add some gobos, which is texture for the light itself. So let's first add a spotlight. Let's make sure it's lighting up this scene nicely and let's increase it. Yeah, we probably have to increase the spot size. That looks good. And now make sure the spotlight is selected, go into use nodes and let's add a gobo. So a gobo might look like this. or this, or this, or this, depending on what you're going to use it for. It basically applies this image as a texture for the light. So let's choose this one. And all of this is in the Patreon, of course. Drag it into the shader editor, connect it to color. The shadows are a bit sharp right now, so let's go into the light settings. And let's increase the radius slightly, like this, I think. And then just position the shadows exactly how you want it to look. All right, that's about it. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.
You made it to the end of the video. That means you're dedicated to learning. And if you want to take your Blender skills seriously or you just need something to stay committed, I just launched a Patreon. And at the third tier, you can send me your blend file and I will record a personal video giving feedback on your project every single month. Link in the description. All right, thanks for watching and see you next time.